Now let's find that car. Gotta keep close to it. This harbor's a pretty big place.
Hello everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Hitman Contracts. Today we're going to be doing the mission Deadly Cargo. This is a mission with only one objective in it, which is to eliminate an arms dealer named... Well, to be honest with you, I can't pronounce his name. Luckily though, he also goes by Boris, which I can pronounce. So I'm just going to call him Boris from now on. This mission is actually a complete remake of two missions from the original game, Hitman Codename 47. The two missions being A Gunrunner's Paradise and Plutonium Runs Loose. The only real difference is pretty much every objective in those missions is gone because there's only one now. And in general, it's just become more simple, more easy, and even more linear. So to get caught up with my own video here, basically we've come through that strip bar to the basement, and we had to wait for the guard that patrols around in the basement here to go into the one room that he can't see us at the bottom. That way we could actually get through. We're not supposed to be down there, which is why we had to wait. Now, the bikers aren't going to cause an alert, blow your cover, and start shooting at you just because you're down there. But they'll come and tell you to leave. At which point, if you dilly-dally or ignore everything they say, then they'll start shooting at you. But if they just come and tell you to leave, you can just get out and wait a bit, come back, and try again. That outside area we were just through is actually completely empty, including that hallway we went through as well. So there's nothing to be worried about there. However, right now we are in a police compound. And the police compound actually works exactly the same way as the bikers. They'll come and tell you to leave, but they won't start shooting at you unless they have a good reason to, such as ignoring everything they just said. Also trying to get caught up with my own video here, at the beginning, he did talk about a car that he has to stick by. We actually kind of left it. The car that he was talking about was... Well, it's actually that one there. It's also the one that was right outside the strip bar, if you saw it. Basically, the plot to this mission is... Boris is buying a nuclear bomb from the biker gang, Flaming Rotterdam, which we actually saw in the last mission. The bomb is being delivered via car, which is being loaded onto the boat as you just saw. The first two or three policemen that patrol the compound area are actually all around the two trucks next to where we came out. There's only one small space where they can see you, so it's really easy to get by them. The last guy just kind of patrols around his area in a bit of a box path. If he's on the right side when you get here, you're better off waiting by that crate for him to pat by there and slip through. Our goal right now is actually to get to this little shack here, because this shack has a disguise that'll let us into the harbor area. Basically, most of this mission, given the fact that it only has one objective, is going from disguise to disguise to objective to disguise to disguise, then leaving. It's kind of time-consuming, but... Well, it's the way I got it done. Now, because it's a silent assassin run, as you just saw, I threw away my guns. There's a toolbox in there. If you wanted to really bring in one of your guns, you could hide it in there. Because right now, we're going to get frisked.
Стойте, пожалуйста, спокойно, сэр.
Why they insist on patting down my clothes to check for weapons, but don't bother to check a toolbox, I have no idea. But hey, I'm not complaining. So there we go, the entire reason we have this disguise is just to get in here. We can't actually get onto the boat that we need to in this disguise. We have to go get one of those guard disguises, which is in this middle warehouse. Now, if we go in the warehouse, we're going to get shot at, because we're not supposed to be in there. So we're going to go a little more clever way. We have a sewer system. Okay, so maybe it's not that clever. This underground sewer system actually connects the harbor to the three warehouses that are also on the map. two of the warehouses, the north and south one, are occupied by SWAT teams. The middle one is occupied by Boris's guards. And it's also where we can get a spare thug disguise. And by thug, I mean guard. I'm probably going to switch those words out every now and then. So, in this disguise, either one of them, they're going to start shooting at me because, well, I'm not supposed to be in there. But if we can hide away, because these pats are honestly pretty stupid. We just got to wait for this one to come out. As for the disguises themselves, there's the one I'm wearing right now, where the only real thing you have access to that you wouldn't without a disguise is that harbor area, but you do get frisked. There's a policeman disguise, where you will not be able to get to the harbor area, for obvious reasons. There's the pat we've been waiting for. But you can walk around the police compound area without them kicking you out. You can also go into the north and south SWAT-controlled warehouses. You can get a biker disguise in the beginning, but honestly, that is going to do jack all for you. You can walk around the strip club in the places that you would be told to get out if you weren't in a biker uniform. But in all honesty, there's no point in being up there long enough to necessitate a disguise. The last one is this one, this thug disguise. This is the one we actually need if we want to do a silent assassin run. Not only does it let us around this warehouse here and the harbor area, we can actually get onto the boat with it. Keeping in mind though, we are in a guard's disguise, and it follows guard disguise rules. You cannot let anyone see your face, you cannot dilly-dally, and just all in all, stay away from as many guards as you possibly can. That becomes a problem because, well, we're going on a boat, and boats tend to have really narrow hallways. If at any point you're in a hallway and you come up to another guard, get out of the hallway, or just turn around and walk the other way. Be patient and you won't be caught. Now, this isn't the way we're going to get to Boris, but I just want to show this door here is a kitchen area. Boris does stop in there for a while, and you can get him silently in there. The problem is, there's also a few patrols that go in there. And if they find it, you've caused an alert. Now, causing one or two alerts, actually, maybe only one, it's not gonna completely ruin your silent assassin run. You are given a bit of leeway in that regard. But you also don't want to really risk it, just in case something else happens. Where we're gonna take Boris out is actually just around the corner here at his second stop area. Just in here, there's one more door right here, and this is kind of Boris's, I guess, his office and bedroom or something. He stops in there and no one else goes in there. So he's not there now, we gotta wait for him. I found up here is a decent place to wait because no one really pats up here. That red circle right there, that'd be Boris. He goes across that walkway twice, one on the bottom, one on the walkway to his actual room. So let's check. Yeah, he's on the walkway. That's convenient. So we're gonna go take him out. I will mention also in the kitchen area, there is a knife you can use if you so desire. The wire will kill him, and it'll do a perfectly fine job. I guess the knife is just if you're feeling particularly stabby today. But there he is. He doesn't suspect a thing. There we go. I'm glad no one heard that. We don't have to, but just for shits and giggles, let's take his stuff. He's got a bomb detonator, and he's got a magnum. Alright, now we just gotta get out of here. There's no guards around, keeping in mind we're in narrow spaces, we can't really risk anything. Gotta get our asses off this boat. At this point, I almost got caught there. Anyway, at this point, the entire mission is the same thing backwards. So, I'm going to speed that up because it's going to get repetitive. And in the meantime, I'm going to go over a few extra little details about the mission I didn't get to earlier. First of all, about the Silent Assassin run, the disguise specifically. To begin with, I could have easily syringed a policeman earlier and taken his disguise and have been fine that way. The problem with that is, it takes so long to get to and from each disguise and onto the boat to do the objective, and then back to the other disguises. By the time you're ready to leave, the syringed person would have woken up by then, and whatever disguise he used to get to the thug disguise would be completely useless. You wouldn't be able to use that one anymore because your cover would be blown in that disguise. That's why I had to go and get a spare disguise that wasn't being used. There is another option for a spare disguise, but I had a lot of trouble getting to it, and I'll show that off a little later. As for the previous game missions that this is based off of, the first one was the mission Gunrunner's Paradise. The entire point of that mission was to find out where Boris was. The objectives you had there was you had to put a GPS tracker in a money suitcase and give it off to a right-hand man to kind of complete the purchase for the actual bomb, and the GPS tracker be brought to the boat and we'd know where they are. Since nothing like that happens and we kind of start off knowing where Boris is, I don't understand why Gunrunner's Paradise is technically one of the missions that this was a remake of. The other one, however, is Plutonium Runs Loose. That one makes a lot more sense, because that's the actual Kill Boris mission. That being said, there's actually more that you had to do to it. You actually had three objectives there. You had to take the ship and pilot it out to international waters before you eliminated them. And you had to disarm the bomb. I didn't mention it before, but it is actually not an objective in this mission to disarm the bomb. All you have to do is Boris. You can leave that bomb active. No one gives a crap. As long as Boris gets killed, you're cool. That's all you're paid to do. There are a bit other ways that I'm going to show off in a bit that you absolutely have to do it to get that done. And you'll see why when we do it. But in this section, we didn't have to. One of the really interesting things about this mission I've found is the other methods you can do things in, you can still get Silent Assassin rating with. Usually in the missions, you have one way where you can get Silent Assassin, the other ways are just for shits and giggles. You can actually get it in every way, I think, in this mission, which you will see in just a moment. So since getting a disguise is such a big part of this mission, I figure I'll start it off with the bonus sections. In that shack over there I just showed off, that's one of the policemen that actually guard the compound area. We need to get him isolated. Let's shut off his porn. That'll get that dirty bastard moving. Honestly, while we're waiting for him, we can just stand right here, right next to that signal cutoff box, and apparently he doesn't put it together that we were the ones that did that. He'll just come over and try and turn it back on so we can go back to doing whatever the hell it was he was doing. Quite frankly, I don't want to know. While he's doing that, we'll just sneak up behind him. I'm going to use a syringe here, because I'm not a monster. If you wanted to, you could just shoot him in the head. But if you wanted to do Silent Assassin, and if you think you're fast enough to get it done, the police disguises, to me, is actually a quicker way to get to that thug disguise. There is a spare police uniform you can get to, and honestly, I could not get to it. I tried so many times trying to get to that police uniform, and I failed miserably, which is why I had to eventually just go for the dock worker one. The spare uniform is actually in here. This is like the actual police station. Right over here is the locker room. And obviously that's where the disguise would be. Right next to it is a pistol that you don't actually really need to get, but I don't know, if you really wanted to feel the immersion of being a policeman, you could grab the gun. Now in that bottom room there, that's the actual room that you would come in to find this police uniform. There's two entrances to it, one's to the right, one's to the left. The left one, however, is next to a bunch of dogs. And if you remember from the mansion mission, the dogs set off the alarms. So this here is the door you'd come through, and that's the guard that never moved. Are you freaking kidding me? Now you're gonna move? This guard was the bane of my existence. He would not move when I was trying to get that uniform. As for the dock worker uniform, there's a really elaborate way to get this uniform, and I'm gonna show that off right here. It's honestly, it's not really practical. You would do this if you just wanted to go for the coolness factor of it, and it's really all not all that cool. Up at the top here in the bathroom is some rat poison. Down in the basement, there's a bottle of whiskey. I think you know where I'm going with this. And since we've poisoned someone in pretty much the past, I don't know, is it 3 videos? Might as well keep that going. Now back up here, in order to get things rolling, you have to talk to this guy.
The police has sent us all home. No working, we're just drinking.
Why did they send you home?
Something about a boat on Pier 1. I don't know. I'm out of whiskey. It's time for the bartender to get a new bottle from the basement.
Talking to him will actually trigger the events for him to get poisoned. Now, with the car, there is an optional objective that you can do with it. I didn't do it in Silent Assassin because it wasn't necessary.
Guy by that car over there is a friend of mine. Maybe you could cheer him up.
I can cheer any man up for 250.
Here's a grand. Make him ecstatic. And take your time.
Ugh. Every time I hear that woman's voice, I have to shudder. I don't understand how that could be attractive to anyone. But anyway, it's working for that biker. And he's the one guarding the car. Now that he's not guarding the car, we can tamper with it. And by tamper with it, I mean just place a GPS tracker in the bottom. Now let's go check on that dock worker. Holy crap, you're still waiting for your whiskey? This bar has shitty service. So, that means we're waiting too. There we go. He's had his whiskey, he took a drink. Oh, he doesn't look so good now. Let's follow him. He goes up to the top, into one of these unused rooms, and he just kind of collapses. Poor little dock worker. That was unnecessary. Let's take his clothes. That entire method was really long and elaborate, and honestly, it was a waste of time. Now, I'm back in the police uniform because, like I said, I like the police uniform. It's easier. Also, we can go into these SWAT-infested warehouses. Specifically, we're in the southern warehouse right now. We're actually going to do a different way of killing Boris. If you go up to the top on the opposite end of where you came out of the sewer system, yes, you have to go through the sewer system to get here. The only entrances are out by the harbor, and they're going to shoot any cops that come over there. Anyway, if you go into this room here, there's a ladder that'll bring you to the roof. On the roof is another SWAT member. He will shoot at you if you're up here. So, it's best to take him out. Now, why was this guy on the roof? Well, he's a sniper, of course. Poisoning, check. Sniping? Check. And that guy's probably going to cause some ruckus, so let's take him out too. There we go. Right, method one finished. Method two also requires us to go into the SWAT warehouses. Unfortunately, we also have to wait for this guy here. We need to take his uniform. And To take his uniform, we have to get behind him and either syringe him or wire him. And he's a bit of a pain in the ass, because he walks around in circles like an idiot. You'll see that when he comes back in here. That would be the door. And that would be our SWAT member. See, look, getting behind him, and he turns around. He goes back to the door, and he turns around. He goes back to the boxes. Let's just take him out. Now, I said earlier you can get Silent Assassin with any method that I'm going to show off here. You can't do it if you're just going to kill them. But if you want to get the Silent Assassin and not kill them, it takes a bit more effort. In the case of this method, you have to be kind of fast about it. And the problem with being fast about it is you have to wait for triggers, so you're almost not in control of how fast it can go. As for the other way with the sniping, it's kind of even worse, but I'll get into that later. Basically, what we're doing right now is we have taken that SWAT member's place in his squad. I'm just gonna listen to the radio for a moment. There it is. That was our signal, so we're gonna get going. Now, the South Warehouse and the North Warehouse both have a SWAT team in it. The Southern Warehouse is kind of phase one of the SWAT mission. They take out the first wave of enemies, basically all the ones that are on top of the boat and in front of it, and they kind of make way for the second team. The second team is the one that actually goes into the boat itself. If you wanted to get straight to the action, you could go down to the Southern Warehouse and wire someone there. But I was a bit lazy about it, and honestly, I'd rather stick with this team because they're actually going to go in the boat. I will mention, this mission, I don't have a Rambo-style method for, because this mission doesn't allow for a Rambo style. But what we're doing right now, sorry about that, was listening to the radio there. Right there he said begin phase 2, that means we get to start going onto the boat. Anyway, the method I'm doing right now is kind of the replacement for the Rambo style mission. Later on you will see exactly why I can't do a Rambo of this. But the reason this is a replacement of it is, while we're doing this, we can shoot people. That's right, we can actually open fire and kill guards and does not blow our cover. Because we're in this SWAT team and this is what we're supposed to be doing. Again, if you wanted Silent Assassin, you would have to follow them around and not shoot anyone. There's our signal, they're actually going to start going in. And since I've already shown a Silent Assassin way, I'm going to have some fun here. I'm going to start shooting guards. Ah, satisfying. Right, so everyone's starting to go down to the bottom here, and we actually have to go down here too, so that works out. There's about 4 or 5 guards down here.
I just armed a nuclear device. If I drop this detonator, it will detonate in seconds. My safety is your safety.
Hey, Борис Иванович, ты чего? Если тебя застрелят, нам всем кранты.
If you're shot, we'll all die.
That matters to me, because as for negotiations, there will be none. My terms are simple. One fully fueled chopper this deck in 20 minutes. No heroes. Anyone follows me, everyone dies. Everyone.
This conversation is over.
That is why we can't do a Rambo style. If we were to just run around shooting everyone, we would get blown up because it's going to set off the bomb. Now, at the same time, that is also kind of what makes this method and the sniper method more of a pain in the ass than they need to be. Because before we go and kill them, now we have to disarm the bomb. Like he said, if we went up there and just killed him, he'd drop the detonator and blows everything up. Oh, if only we knew where that bomb was, though. Oh wait, we put a GPS tracker on that car, didn't we? That would be why we did that option was there. Now, going back to the sniper method, if you wanted to use that for the silent assassin, you would have to wait for the SWAT team to start going in, because that's when the sniper actually turns his back to the hole you come out of and he won't kill you there. But at the same time, after so long, Boris will start threatening to blow the place up. So even if you wanted to use that method, you would have to still take a SWAT disguise, come in here, and disarm the bomb. Which we have just done. So now we're free to kill Boris all we want. Now the problem with that is, one, the SWAT members were told that they have to take Boris alive. Also, they're under the belief that if anyone goes near him, he's going to blow everyone up. So once we take any steps towards Boris, they're kind of going to shoot us. At this point, the SWAT is just as much an enemy as the guards are. So, if you can't hide from them, you're also still gonna have to blow your silent assassin run. This is why I didn't use this method for my example. It's much harder to do. Bit more of a pain in the ass. Also, it's just fun to shoot people. Especially in a game where kind of the point is to not shoot people. So, bombs disarmed. We're actually going up to where I was waiting for Boris earlier in the silent assassin run, up that ladder. He will not be in his office because he's up at the top. Just hang it right here. And a left. And there's our guy. There we go. Boris is dead. No one's gonna get exploded because we disarmed that bomb. Now, getting out, that could be a problem because they're gonna shoot at us. This is why we're gonna threaten their lives. If you take the detonator and keep it equipped, or not equipped, but you don't put it away, he walks around with it held up high like this. Basically meaning, if you shoot me, you blow up. This kind of makes us almost as bad as Boris, but my conscience is clear, we turned off the bomb. In a game where the whole point is not shooting people and stealth and being like into disguises and stuff, I find it's really satisfying to actually have a legitimate way of doing a mission where you can run in and just start shooting people without your cover being blown. And it's incredibly satisfying to just walk out holding the detonator up high. That could just be me being a bit weird, though. Anyway, that's about it for this episode. Thank you for watching. I'm going to be waltzing out here with the detonator. And see you later.